Key of Clock Tower and Time Twister price is skyrocket as it is needed for a high-end upgrade of any equipment. But player from a lower class just doesn't have the access to grind on the field MVP. The good thing is endless towers sometimes double spawn Spashire or Time Holder in the same floor. But unfortunately, Spashire is so powerful here. Just because he is so powerful, are you going to give up and miss the chance of getting those materials? Anyway, this is the guide to tank double Spashire. So the first important thing is a good tank need a good damage dealer. My team is consists of high priest, a random guild member, a demigod and an asshole. Considering I have one asshole in my team, you probably have a better team than I do. Next is about the stats and attribute. So I have 99 feet and 90 intelligence, and the rest of my attribute you can see it by yourself. For the equipment, I have +8 imperial shield with mark card. It will be better if you just use static shield. I use this shield because it's already just +8. And I have goibness set with dokaibi card in the armor, endurance necklace, saint necklace, and goblin leader mask. Also in the weapon I have meta an egg. And that's it for the equipment. For the rune, I just need 4 taunt damage reduction and 2 taunt range. So if you have more gold medal or contribution, it will be better. And this is my skills. I have level 10 taunt, level 5 devotion, level 10 endure, level 5 selfless shield, level 20 heal, level 10 faith, level 20 divine protection, level 10 reflex shield, level 10 auto guard, level 10 providence, and level 5 bliss. With this build, I can easily tank the time holder in 90th floor. Or actually, if you can tank Spashire, you can just tank any MVP you want. And 2 Spashire, 2 time holder, I still ain't got shit